Good morning. Before we just start here, I'll tell you that I am Carol Jean's first cousin, so I'm related to about everybody in here. But she has asked me to do this, and I'm very honored to do this service for Alfred, because Alfred was a great guy. So we'll just start with a little greeting here. This morning we've gathered to remember and to celebrate the life of Alfred, and to pray that God will comfort and strengthen Carol Jean, Sunita, Jeff, Christy, and of course his brother Don, and Tracy, his daughter. Confident that God always remembers the good things we have done and forgives our sins, let us pray, asking God to gather Alfred to himself. So let us pray. Lord God, from whom human sadness is never hidden, you know the burden of grief that we all feel at the loss of Alfred. As we mourn his passing from this life, comfort us with the knowledge that Alfred lives now in your loving embrace, in his eternal home in your heavenly kingdom. We make our prayer through Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen.
Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my
good morning. My name is Tracy. I'm Alfred's niece, and it was asked that I read his obituary, and I'm honored to do so. Alfred L. Brown, 87, of Apache, Oklahoma, passed away peacefully at his home, surrounded by his family, on November 19, 2021. Alfred was born at Fort Sill, Oklahoma, on June 16, 1934, to Jack B. and Elizabeth Young Brown. Alfred was from a military family and lived in different locations. Some of those were Cement, Oklahoma, Fort Logan, Colorado, Cache, Oklahoma, and Lawton, Oklahoma. Alfred drove a truck for many years with different companies. He was employed with Lawton Public Schools for 30 years, from 1971 to 2001. He met Carol Jean Allen on a blind date, and they were later married on July 31, 1964, in Wichita Falls, Texas. From this marriage was born Sunita Burchett, Jeff Brown, and Christy Woodhouse. Alfred liked the simple pleasures in life. He enjoyed sitting on the porch and watching old movies, classic TV shows like Perry Mason, Adam 12, and Gomer Pyle. He had a vast collection of old movies, and his favorite actor was John Wayne. He loved wearing his John Wayne jacket and hat. He enjoyed lounging in his recliner watching TV with his eyes shut. If you dared to change the channel when you thought he was asleep, he would quickly say, "I'm watching that." He cherished his American Rifleman magazines, and he loved to doodle and draw on the newspaper, on magazine pages, or even on the old TV guide. He also had a collection of a variety of guns. Alfred was always prepared. He never went anywhere without his flashlight, his hat, and his fly swatter. He frequently gave his wife and children flashlights and calendars as gifts to ensure that they were always prepared too. In his younger years, Alfred rode a motorcycle with his friends and kept his leather motorcycle jacket and gear in his garage for many years. Alfred enjoyed hunting with his friends and family, especially in eastern Oklahoma. Alfred is survived by his wife of the home, three children, two daughters, Sunita Burchett, of Oklahoma City, and Christy Woodhouse of Irving, Texas, and one son, Jeff Brown, and his fiance, Terry Jacobson of Joplin, Missouri. Three grandchildren, Jordan Woodhouse of Puyallup, Washington, Devin Burchett of Oklahoma City, and Aria Brown of Lansing, Michigan. One brother, Donald Y. Brown of Apache, Oklahoma, and many other family and friends. He is preceded in death by his parents, one sister, Evelyn Walker, and one brother, Bill Brown. The family would like to thank his special caregivers, Donna Gitchell, Jessica Day, and Ann Bird. All three of these ladies went above and beyond to care for my Uncle Alfred. I speak for the whole family when I say thank you for that. And finally, in the words of John Wayne, "When the road looks rough, remember the man upstairs and the word H-O-P-E. Hang on to both and tough it out." And if you'll please bow your head and join me with this prayer, please. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table for me in the presence of my enemies, for thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all of the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
Talking with the family on Sunday about scripture reading for Alfred, they all, you know, seem to agree on this one right here. This scripture reading comes from Matthew chapter 11, On one occasion, Jesus spoke thus, "I give praise to you, Lord, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your precious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light." Amen. And Tracy, thank you for that wonderful prayer, the 23rd Psalm. The scripture that I just read from Matthew tells us something about Alfred. While searching for, well, I just mentioned this, for searching for a scripture that fit Alfred, Carol Jean, the other, Sunita, Christy, and Don all agreed that this one fit Alfred perfectly. As this reading tells us, no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. And last Friday, Jesus revealed God to Alfred. I've known Alfred since he married Carol Jean, my cousin, in 1964. He was always a joy to be around and was fun to talk with. Just from talking with him and being around him, you knew he was a good Christian person. And Alfred was not afraid of hard work either. While he supported three children, he worked two jobs. Days were spent at Lawton Public Schools, and at night drove a mail truck to Oklahoma City. He got up every morning, never complaining, just to do it all over again. This reminds me of another scripture from Matthew. The Son of Man did not come to live his life as Christ. Alfred lived his life as Christ, serving others, not being served. He was a very private person, putting others before himself. One of the many things he did after he retired was caring for his mother-in-law, Evelyn, or Epi, as we nieces and nephews fondly called her, while Carol Jean was working. Alfred was a huge John fan, of John Wayne, and collected John Wayne memorabilia. And I see also he's taken some with him. He has a hat and a coat on, and probably something else in there I didn't see. He also had a large collection of old movies. These movies were a great consolation to him, since he watched them over and over during his homebound time. I guess I've heard since most every time I went to see him, he always had his eyes closed, but now after reading this Tracy read, I guess he was probably watching them anyway with his eyes closed, and I didn't know it. But he had one on all the time, every time I was there. There are a couple of amusing stories or more that I want to share about Alfred with you today. The first one, these two girls probably don't want me to talk about, Christy and Sunita. Might be embarrassing to them, but that's a long time ago. Especially when Alfred was remodeling their bathroom, he took out the commode, and instead of hauling it off, he left it in the front yard of the house. I think it was Sunita mostly that begged him to get rid of that. It was an embarrassment to her when the bus came by and picked them up and everything, but he refused, saying that someone would need it and they would pick it up. And he was correct about that, but it took forever, but some finally did pick it up. And that was a great relief to them, but I think it sat out there for quite a long time. And another time, Alfred was overhauling the engine of his car, and rather than working on it outside, he pulled it out and took it into the living room floor and worked on it in the living room floor for what seemed like an awful long time. And that was probably, knowing what I know about those engines and everything, that was a pretty good mess. And I have one from Don that I just had to talk to him about this morning, about Alfred and a lawnmower. And Don, at, you know, these front wheel, these self-propelled lawnmowers, you got to hold the handle down. But I think Alfred tied his down with a strap. And you know what happened then. And then he was mowing and had a really bad allergy attack and started sneezing and no way to stop the lawnmower. He just had to get down on his knees and raise the lawnmower up and keep on sneezing. And I think Don was going down the street and he stopped and laughed at him a while before he helped him get it straightened out. But the moral to this story is, what goes around comes around, because now Don is having allergy attacks pretty good. So let's laugh at somebody like that. And Jordan and Devin and Aria, your papa was very unique. Just one of the many things that I liked about him. He did a lot of very unique things. After Carol Jean retired, she and Alfred loved to drive around the countryside, enjoying the beautiful scenery. Visiting friends, I know Alfred would have to stop every once in a while and visit with somebody along the way. And they enjoyed eating out. A favorite place to eat was Ann's Country Kitchen. The staff enjoyed Alfred and nicknamed him Mr. Hungry. Alfred loved to eat almost anything, except he didn't like frozen dinners. The kids, however, liked frozen dinners. But so Carol Jean never fixed him a frozen dinner, but they always had the kids had their chances for frozen dinners at night when Alfred was driving his mail truck. So they got their frozen dinners. Alfred's favorite thing to eat was ice cream. He would hold his head up here, you know, when you get a brain freeze, but just keep on eating ice cream. Alfred and Carol Jean truly loved each other, enjoyed spending time together, and Carol Jean was the only girl Alfred dated. And they were married about a year after they met each other. They eloped to Wichita Falls. But what was really great about this couple is that everywhere they went, they held hands. Walking, whatever they did, they held hands. And even fell asleep at night holding hands. Very, very, very beautiful thing to do. Very beautiful. And Carol Jean and Don and Christy knew Alfred was so tired of struggling, but he was a strong-willed person and wanted to stay with Carol Jean as long as possible. God knew it was time to call him home. He had suffered enough. And Alfred's death reminds all of us that although we're here on this earth right now and doing our daily lives and everything and going through our lives, this is only our temporary home. We're only temporarily here. If you go back and think of all of your relatives way back, grandparents and things that have passed away, we're only here temporarily, you know, just a blink of the eye. And our eternal home, and that's where Alfred is, our eternal home is in heaven. And I know that Carol Jean, she did this this was done already, but I know she wants to thank the three special caregivers that she had, Donna and Jessica and Annie. I met two of these, and I didn't see the third one, but these are just very wonderful, wonderful people to be there to take care of Alfred. It was a great blessing for Carol Jean, I know, and for Don, who were there, for have somebody there like that to take care of him. And And Carol Jean and Sunita, Jeff, Christy, Don, and Lane, Jackie, and of course, Tracy, who's done a wonderful job here this morning, too. Thank you. All of you made Alfred's final years on this earth as comfortable as possible for him. Medication made his last months bearable, but now he is no longer suffering. He's now in the hands of God, and that is a wonderful place to be. And all of us here, still here in our earthly homes, are hoping and praying that one day we're in the hands of God, because that's where we all finally want to wind up, be when we pass away, be in our eternal home in heaven in the hands of God, like Alfred is. And Don over there, a very special thank goes to you for all you have done for Alfred and Carol Jean. You, Don, are an exceptional example of how to show love for your family with all you did for them. And Don, your reward will be out of this world, if you know what I mean. Your reward will be out of this world. God will take care of you. That's what that means for what all you've done. And as our Bible reading tells us, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. That's what we were talking about Sunday when we were talking about Alfred, is the fact that this come to me, all who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Because he labored a lot throughout his life, and that's where that part about Christ comes in, is Christ came to serve, not be served. We look at Alfred that way, and most all of us are that way. We come to serve others, and we don't necessarily ourselves want to be served. We're here to make life comfortable for others. And Alfred, I know, served others. And I know Don over there with what he did. He served God without, and he asked to not be served. Just stepped right up and took care of Alfred. And I also know, Lane, that you had a beautiful house for them, for Alfred, for his final months and years. You had a wonderful place for him to be, a wonderful, comfortable place. A big thank you for that. And it's a wonderful place for your dad to be, too, because that's a beautiful little house. And also to labor, as he labored throughout his life. I just named two things he did, the mail truck and the Lawton Public Schools, but he did a number of other things too. Some of these things you just have to talk to the kids about. They know all of these, but he was no lazy person. He worked his life, but he also enjoyed life, and he was a pleasure to be around. I especially liked to go out and eat with him, because he was I was wondering why the waitresses wouldn't maybe say, maybe you just should leave or something. You're pestering me too much. But no, he was a good guy. He was a really good guy. But he earned his rest, his eternal rest, as you might say. He had earned his eternal rest last Friday. And so, Alfred, welcome into your heavenly kingdom, where God is there with you, all is great. I mean, you're in a wonderful place, and I know it's so beautiful where you are, God, that you're just telling all your Carol Jean and the kids, just don't worry about me. I'm fine now, and I will be up here watching you and praying for you, and I have a place for you when you come. But again, I thank you, Carol Jean, for allowing me to be here today and do this, and all of you kids especially, and Christy and Sunita and Jeff for all the work you did. I thank you for all of this. And could we all at this time please join together and say our Lord Jesus Christ prayer, the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, I'll say this together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, would anyone have anything they'd like to share with us about Alfred's life or the family's life or anything at this time? I know I told some stories, but I know there's got to be plenty more. But I will leave that up to you. Give you a few minutes here to think about it.
So when we were little kids, this is how Daddy woke us up in the morning. You can't get him up in the morning. Do you know how annoying that was?
Yep, that's what you said the other day. Yep. Yep.
Mama always had to cook three meals. Had to every day. My dad was like,
no frozen dinners, though, right?
My mom always had time, 7 days a week. But recently, Terry came home with me.
I'm going to tell him. When I first met him, he introduced himself. You know, we had our little greetings, and he said, we were talking about food and how Jeff has taken after him. He loves to eat. And so he proceeded to tell me, he said, well, he said, good luck with him. You can't afford him.
And then I had been turned a couple of times.
A few minutes later, he said, and then he said, he's been retired once.
Yeah, I know Alfred was always good for a laugh. He'd make you feel good talking to him and everything. I guess he was a serious person. They said he was, but to me, he just never didn't seem like the real serious type. As far as what I saw of him, he was just more of an easygoing person that kind of let it flow, just hit him and just flow off. So, but I don't know. But I know. Of course, I've got pretty well acquainted with Don going to see Alfred, and what I know of Alfred and what I know of Don, they weren't just exactly alike in the way they acted and all of that. But I know they're really good guys, and I know Don's a really good guy too, and Don's had his share of hardships too. But we just use our faith. Our faith in God is what gets us through these times, and the thoughts of knowing that Alfred is now free of all pain and everything, and he's no more pain. That leg is all better now, and walking around up there telling everybody about John Wayne, probably. I don't know, but I know he's not the only John Wayne fan. And the way the kids talk, there's a lot of John Wayne memorabilia out there that somebody might want to look at just to see what all he had. But anyway, if we could just pray now. Let us pray. Into your hands, God, we humbly entrust our brother and friend, Alfred. In this life, you embraced him with your tender love. Deliver Alfred now from every evil and bid him enter into eternal life. Welcome Alfred then into paradise, where there will be no sorrow, nor weeping, no pain, but the fullness of peace and joy forever and ever. And God, we know that Alfred is enjoying every bit of this peace and rest and comfort that he is getting now. And we just know that we need to continue praying for Alfred daily, and we need to continue praying for ourselves daily. And just know that Alfred is now in the loving hands of God, as I said a while ago. Amen.
That saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour
Happy birthday.
I heard they murdered women and children in the Larks race.
I heard that too.
Carol Jean, happy birthday to you.
Oh, I mean, what side were you on?
And now the end is near, so I face the final curtain.
my friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. What I had to do, and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more. Show.